The year 2020 was an exceptional one due to the global COVID-19 pandemic. Despite this, for Valmet it was a relatively good year as most of our key operating metrics improved. The comparable EBITDA increased for the 7th year in a row. But let's start first with orders, which unfortunately decreased. The total order intake for the year amounted to 3.7 billion euros, which is 8% lower than last year. Orders received remained at the previous year's level of over 1 billion euros in paper, and also remained at the previous year's level in automation when including the package sales to capital projects. Orders decreased in the pulp and energy and services business lines. While the pandemic has not caused major impacts on Valmet's capital and automation businesses, the services business has been under pressure due to various travel restrictions, access restrictions to customer sites, as well as lower capacity utilization in the graphical paper mills. Let's then move to the net sales and profitability. Our net sales amounted to 3.7 billion euros and increased in the capital business and remained at previous year's level in the stable business. Profitability developed well and the comparable EBITDA increased 16% to 365 million euros. This represents 9.8% of our net sales, close to our new target range of 10-12%, which was introduced 1 year ago. The comparable EBITDA increased due to higher net sales and lower SG&A expenses. For example, the increased use of industrial internet and remote connections resulted in lower travel expenses in 2020. It is also worth mentioning that Valmet's investment in Neles did not impact the comparable EBITDA figure. The board of directors has decided to propose a dividend of 90 euro cents per share. This would equal 58% of the net result, and it would be 10 euro cents higher than the dividend paid for 2019. So those were the key figures for 2020, and next we move on to the acquisitions. In recent years, Valmet has followed its acquisition strategy of making well-considered acquisitions with the clear industrial logic. In 2020, we strengthened our board and tissue technology offering by acquiring PMP Group in Poland. PMP's offering of small and medium-sized tissue machines and board and paper machine rebuilds complements Valmet's offering for wide and fast machines well. In June 2020, we also acquired a 14.9% ownership in Neles and gradually increased the ownership to 29.5% of the company. We see that the potential merger of Valmet and Neles would create a Nordic-based global leader with a unique offering for global process industries and with excellent potential for long-term shareholder value creation. If we then look at how the year 2021 looks for Valmet at this point, our guidance for 2021 is that both net sales and comparable EBITDA will remain at the same level as they were in 2020. The short-term market outlook was upgraded in automation and tissue, but downgraded in energy. We continue to see the outlook good for pulp and for board and paper. The COVID-19 related restrictions continue to impact our services business, and therefore the outlook there is satisfactory/weak. So when looking at the bigger picture, Valmet's business is supported by favorable megatrends. We have a solid order backlog and have improved our profitability every year since we became an independent company at the end of 2013. Valmet is starting the year 2021 from a good position.